we're moving into an era of multiple poles of growth. The darker the color, the red, that shows the growth using a five-year average. And this is important because the emerging markets are helping global demand. So the message is that the developing world is part of the solution both today and for the future. Developing countries are increasingly the engine of global growth. You'll see the bars on the left side. That shows contributions to GDP growth between 2000 and 2010, so over the course of the decade. And you can see that developing countries are now about half the source of global growth. On the right, you see the role of developing countries contributing over half of the recovery to global imports. IDA, our fund for the poorest. This helps 79 of the poorest countries, about half in sub-Saharan Africa, and it's absolutely fundamental for the Millennium Development Goals. Now, many of the donors are under funding pressure. Many of them have focused on bilateral programs. But IDA is truly unique because it allows ownership by developing countries, which we've all learned is key for success. It allows clients to decide in an interactive process with us and also other donors. It assists with the coordination. If you've got 30, 40, 50 donors, it's so difficult to do. This is often the cornerstone funding. And critically, it cuts across sectors. When I was at the UN MDG meeting, I couldn't help feeling, yes, there was good work in education, good work in health, good work in water, good work in child or maternal mortality. But people don't fit in boxes and categories. They cut across those. And so if you're trying to deal with an intervention, you have to see how to work across the sectors. We've launched what I think may be one of our most exciting initiatives about open data, open knowledge, open solutions. We've now released 4,000 development indicators, totally accessible and all for free. We've come up with, and a number of these are data that go back decades, country by country. It's a tremendous treasure trove. To give better access, we're coming up with new software tools. So we allow anybody to be able to do their own poverty calculations or use simulation models to come up with their own approach. We've added an open forum to be able to connect people through the internet to the discussions we're having here. We've launched what will be very intriguing to see the result, an Apps for Development competition. So we've asked people to compete, to use our data sources in trying to see how we can better come up with ideas to achieve the Millennium Development Goals. We've launched a very interesting mapping for results process. This will also be something we'll try to show some greater detail to the Development Committee. And I think this has fantastic potential for showing people the work the bank does and engaging them in practical terms. I believe we can come out of this crisis both stronger and wiser. I believe we need to work toward building a new networked international economy and architecture that suits it. We need a more flexible and different approach to development. You are the G187. This is a potentially powerful concept. It's rich and poor. It's north, south, east, west. So we welcome this opportunity to work with you and to build a modernized multilateralism. Thank you.